Hi everyone, this is Grace. How are you? Do you know? Most likely, we would be living all the way up to age 100. And we might be working even around age 80. So it's time for you to redesign your life plan. Let's reevaluate our life plan. And one of the things I'd like to talk today is about your loneliness after retirement. You know, it is a personal preference, not the preference, but it's a personal belief, and you may or you may not agree with me, but I feel what would be the most painful when you become old after retirement? Let's say if you're around age 80 years old, what do you think would be the most painful? I don't think that's disease. I don't think that's poverty. Yes, poverty could be painful too. But most of all, I feel loneliness can be the most painful thing if you have to live long, especially you live up to age 100 and you have loneliness, meaning you have no friends, no family, nobody around you. I think that would be the most painful to a human being. And in addition to money, I was told many seniors are so afraid of running out of their savings after retirement. And also, it is not nice if you have chronic disease and you still have to be somehow dependent, or you have to rely on somebody's help because of your disease or disability. So what we can do? Let's start planning and let's start preventing some of those negative factors. And again, it's all personal preference. Some people belong to church and that would give them a good friendship and maybe money. Maybe your church will support you something. Or if you are sick, still your church people might help you. I don't know. But me personally, I prevent to become a lonely seniors by doing a couple of things. Number one, investments, and number two, all the side projects and side businesses. Because I feel having multiple streams of income, having a good business partners, I think I'll be in a good hand after I retire. So really, I was only 25 years old when I lost my hospital job because my father became sick. He had to go under emergency surgery in Japan. I asked my boss for leave of absence. And back then in the United States, they only had a maternity leave, but they didn't have family leave of absence. So my boss told me, Grace, either you come back tomorrow or you quit. You turned in the letter of resignation. So I have to turn in the letter of resignation to quit. And that's how I learned there was two kinds of income. One is active income, the other is passive income. So it doesn't matter how elite you are. I thought I was the cream of the crop, going to one of the best universities in California, graduate school, from USC and UCLA, and I was working in the hospital, but the minute my father became sick, which was out of my control, and I realized I was a glorified laborer. I thought I was elite. You think you are elite, you are glorified W-2 worker. Something happened to you, you cannot work, your income stopped right there. Or you don't mix with your boss gives you a pink slip, that's it, that's the end of your life or career. But please start thinking about investments, start thinking about side projects. And I'm not promising anything you touch may not grow, okay? You may not prosper every time you do something new. Most chances are you fail. You fail more than you succeed in life. However, you fail, you learn something important. So next time, you're going to be smarter and wiser. And by doing this, eventually, by age 60 or by age 70, you would have multiple streams of income. Income from investment, income from your side businesses, your side projects, whatever. Try to have as many incomes as possible and make them residual income. If you can make them residual income, that's good. And make it as many residual incomes as possible. Then you will be always surrounded by positive, good business partners. So you'll never feel lonely. And you would have multiple streams of residual income. You wouldn't feel poor. And if, like me, if you are doing side projects in health or wellness or beauty and skincare, you can stay younger and healthier seniors. How about that? So that's all for today. It's 1:30 Los Angeles time. I just came back because I had a great gathering with my friends. And we really exchange good ideas, and it's fun. And I think my retirement time will be just like this. So I want you to start thinking about your retirement life, because we would be living all the way up to age 100. Let's start planning residual income. Happiness is residual income. Multiple of them, okay? I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.